On the contrary, I have a contrary view to the mover of this motion. I will therefore argue that demutualization, which this act calls us to do, is now the trend in international business. It is the trend in the sense that long before now, in 1998, Mr. Speaker, Australia has demutualized its own stock exchange. And right now, both the London and the Swedish stock exchange have been demutualized. And even in Africa here, South Africa have demutualized its own stock exchange on the 1st of July of 2007. The extant laws quoted by my honorable colleague have no bearing with what this act sought to do. We are going to pass a law but the speaker is not with me. Well, but he has to rule, but he doesn't even understand what I'm saying. What will he rule about if I finish?
Honorable Sadiq, please yes, continue sir. With your debate.
Mr. Speaker, I said I'm opposed to the position raised by Honorable Lawal, because the trend in the world of business today is that stock exchanges are being demutualized. And the reasons are really simple, Mr. Speaker. Historically, even in Nigeria here, stock exchanges are normally started as private companies that are of mutual benefits to members. They are called companies limited by guarantee. Now, if a company limited by guarantee wants to convert into a company limited by shares, there are processes in the Companies and Allied Matters Act that will convert. The same way a company limited by a private limited liability company converts into a public limited liability company. And the trend has been, as I said, the same thing that happened in Australia, which was the first country to do that in 1998. And today, the London and the Swedish Stock Exchange are also demutualized. And in Africa today, the Johannesburg Stock Exchange, since 1st July of 2007, have been demutualized. If this country demutualized its own stock exchange, the benefits are so enormous that the motion raised by Honorable Lawal cannot stand, because it is not based on any legal support that can sustain the motion he raised. I therefore, Mr. Speaker, oppose this motion and ask my colleagues to support that this bill be read for the second time, so that other members can contribute, so that we can get the country can benefit from the demutualization of Nigeria's stock exchange. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.